What we are going to do right now, we have 10 minutes of presentation, followed by 10 minutes of demo. Okay? If you have any questions, so I got Jose Navi from Interam that will answer you happily after the session. Observit is a very, very fast-growing company. According to the numbers last year, on the fast 50, we came up with more than 3,500% growth in the past 5 years. Very impressive. We have more than 800 customers across the world. All of them are labeled customers working more in the enterprise market. I guess you can recognize some of the labels in here. We also have a global presence. Maybe you know some of the names that I want to. I was told not to mention some of the Turkish names that we have, but we are working very much also for the telecom, financial, and manufacturing sectors in Turkey. We have many, many good reference customers, so you can go out, look for them, and they will be happy to speak with you. We also have the good services of Nebulize, our integrator, channel partner, and Compera as our distributor. Three main reasons why to purchase a product like Observit. Okay? On the left side, you can see third-party vendors monitoring. Meaning people coming from the outside to the inside. Okay? If someone comes physically to your server farm, someone needs to accompany him, right? To go with him physically. But what happens when you come virtually from the outside? Using VPN, you give them token, you give them access, you give them rules and the firewalls to make sure the right person comes inside. But after it's inside already, there's very, very little information what is he doing when that person is inside. So that's the first thing. On Sunday, you can see also compliance. PCI, SOX, ISO, HIPAA, and other compliance, also internal compliance for the organization. We can assist you to obtain compliance very fast, in a lower cost also. On the right-hand side, you can see some examples. Because we have the video and because we have the metadata, everything you do on the videos becomes searchable, becomes metadata, so everything becomes indexed. So we can use it either for troubleshooting, for example, the server is down for any reason, let's take the last session, maybe we can learn from it and understand why the server is down, even in a matter of minutes. You can use us for documentation. For example, we got an expert coming from the outside, fixing something in my server. Okay, let's record this action and tag it. This is how to solve this issue or main function. You can use us also for documentation for something good. You install some application, record yourself doing that installation, use it as a training kit. This is how to install this application. Okay? Of course, you can use us also for forensic, for root cause analysis. And if that happens in the organization, let's look step by step what that person was doing on that server, on that specific application. To those of you who got SIM, a local network, some facts. According to Verizon research, they found out for data breaches, they found out that only 8% of the data breaches that was discovered in enterprise organization, only 8% was discovered by a SIM solution. A SIM, by the way, is going to be a product like MarkSight, Envision, QRadar, Splunk, and others. There are two main reasons why. The first one is, logs being built by developers for debugging, not for security purposes. We surely know that. It is almost impossible to understand from a log file, any log file, what really happened in that session. Almost impossible. What we are doing is we are giving you a simple video of that session from the moment the person logged in till the moment the person is logged out. Everything is being recorded and everything also being indexed. This is that simple. In here, there's no misunderstanding. You know exactly what happened in that session. Second reason is that there are many, many applications. But do not break laws at all. I mean, every law collector, every scene is limited by power to application that manufactures laws, right? You can see many, many examples. I'm talking about desktop laws. I'm talking about Tor, vSphere, Notepad, SPL. And there are a lot of tools that do not break laws at all. They are not breaking laws. It's like a black hole to every scene solution. So we can enrich your scene solution by first finding out all the logs from different applications with unitary logs, enriching your scene with additional information. And second, if you already have a scene, for example, you can use Observe It as real-time monitoring, meaning something happened right now, you can flag your scene, and from the scene itself, you can see exactly the video, even in real-time, what happened right now on your service. We also have a threat detection console. Because we have visibility of all the sessions, you can use us for end cases. For example, what is the most common application that you use in the organization? Nice, but what is the least common application? Maybe we find an application that you are completely unaware that this means for the server. What person has the most big number of sessions? What person has the least number of sessions? Maybe you can find a person that was fired from the organization a few months ago, but still there are sessions under his name. So we can find a lot of end cases because we see all the sessions. We can also track down to daily DBAs. Actually, the people who are working on your databases, every query, every action that the DBA is doing on your database could be recorded and again searchable. It's not just recording, it's also for searching. Observe requires a simple agent to be installed on the monitor device. Say device, it could be a VDI, it could be desktop, Citrix, Windows, Linux, Unix, all sorts of type of operating system. If you put an agent on that device, you can start recording and have a full visibility of what's going on in your premises, in your servers. For example, if you go to a bank, okay, you can use the thing, you go to a bank, there's a camera in the branch, right? You look nice and there's a camera over there, right? But if you go to the bank server, where's the recording? And this is actually what we are doing. So the solution today is very simple. You can see here, you got a security guy. You see that there is some change of the company server. He's not really understand what is the change, you see that there is a change. And he's not know exactly who that person that was performing that change, because it came from administrator. So many companies have what we call shared account or generic accounts, meaning admin at support it again and again. So basically Observe is doing three things. The first one is full video recording. Okay? It's simple but give you a very simple result also. Step by step what happened in the video in that session. Of course we're not recording idle time, meaning person go out, the group is actually child, go back, there's no recording. Okay? Only if you click on something, you change, you modify, you close, you write something, because we have also keyboarding capability, only then fast there is a change and there is a recording. Second thing is that we also give you a full textual analysis of what happened in that video. Not always you have the time to sit down and watch the video. Not always you really know what you are looking for. So we index everything for you. We tell you exactly. We tell you that also, for example, being in that session, it accessed that application, it modified, it viewed, and then it logged out in words. So everything becomes metadata. We can also give you a simple solution for the shared account problem. For example, one of the liabilities in PCI, they make sure that you recognize that person as is, not using your shared account. So we can force your user, maybe privileged users, to access with their own credentials. You also use admin, for example. All the information will be forwarded to your sphere. It will be forwarded digitally signed and encrypted. And basically, that's it. I'm going to show you a very short demo. Now I want to get access to a server using my administrator right. This is something that happens all the time. It's right here. It's always like that in presentation. NKS, I'm logging in as an administrator. Okay, so I want to log in to start working. And there's a pop-up, should be a pop-up from Observer that say, please put your own username and password. Let me exit and re-enter again, hopefully, to do the job. Okay, for the proving it's coming from Gamma, I will tell you that implementation is very, very simple. For example, we are not changing IP, we are not changing the topology, you just install the management console somewhere, and you also use agent of Observer to be deployed, also to be remotely deployed. More than that, for a POC, which is very, very simple, the only thing you need to require a license that Nebula guys or Intera will assist you with, and then you can do a very simple POC. Installing Observer could be in a stealth mode, like a big brother, no one sees. But you can also force the user to click each time. I agree that each time they are going to be installed, they will be recorded. Okay? So it's up to you. The product is very configurable. More than that, we are sitting over there, on a table over there. We will be happy to share with them if that will be revived again. And we'll be happy to explain what you are doing exactly. More than that, we have a very nice gadget as a giveaway. So please pop up by the booth of Observer. And this is a little bit embarrassing, okay? I say Microsoft, but it's not nice to say it in here. In any case, I'm the only one standing between you and lunch. This is not reacting, so it's not cool. So, question for Beshaka, Tam. Questions so far? Ozan is about here? No. So, questions? Come on, I got 5 minutes. Yes, please. Good questions. The question is how much memory that we get, also in terms of CPU and also in terms of storage. Okay? The client is about roughly 4 mega, so it's hardly anything. We take roughly between 0.5% to 2% of CPU. And the recording that we're doing is not a real video. It's actually a player that we wrote, which presents in a video shape the different slides, different screen. Whatever you're doing, you take a screenshot, take a flag. Okay? So a screenshot for me is something like 30K in terms of storage. So the whole video is worth nothing. It's not really video. It's a collection of screenshots. Okay? More questions, please. Don't be shy. I got pressure back. Okay. One person? What time? Do you want to feel able to say a few words and talk about the implementation or the use of the Observer?
Merhaba, Ozan ismi, Kontera'dan. Uygulama çok basit. İhtiyacımız olan Windows 2008 platformunda bir sunucu. Bunun üzerinde IIS'de çalışan bir motor var. Bu motor yükleniyor. Ve client server mimarisinde çalışıyor. Hemen hemen bütün Windows sürümlerinde, gerek client sürümleri, gerek server platformları, bunun yanında da çeşitli Unix platformları, AX, Solaris, Linux gibi türevi özellikle bankalarda veya sigorta risk alanında çalışan kurumlarda farklı platformlarla karşılaşabiliyoruz. Bu platformlara gerekli agentları yükleyerek third party access control, identity theft, secondary authentication gibi çözümlerle kullanabiliyorsunuz. Özellikle secondary authentication kısmı çok kritik çünkü public kullanılan accountlar var kurumlarda. Herkes administrator accountuyla bir şeyler yapmaya çalışıyor. Yani Unix platformunda root access'ler ortak. Ama gerçek anlamda kimin access ettiğini veya işte bir bankaysanız dışarıdan servis aldığınız kurumlar sizin altyapınızda neler yapıyor bunları görmeniz açısından gerçek anlamda monitoring etmeniz gerekiyor. Veya internal audit ile karşılaşıyorsanız geriye dönük auditlerde neler olduğunu görmeniz açısından oldukça kritik. IAS üzerinde çalışan 700 kaldık bir agent var. Unity platformunda da aşağı yukarı size bu şekilde. İsterseniz geriye dönük reportları görebiliyorsunuz. Observit'in en önemli artısı metadata ile video kaydını birleştiriyor olması. Oturup 4 saatlik video kaydını izlemek durumunda değilsiniz. İlgili metadata'yı regex search yaparak, Google'dan bir search yapıyorsunuz. Bu search üzerinden istediğiniz metadata'nın karşılığı olan görüntüleri çok rahatlıkla almanız mümkün. Ve kendi üzerinde bir keylogger sistemi de var. İlla yapılan işlerin enter'a basılması gerekmiyor. Keystroke'larla klavyeye basılan her tuş dizilimi Observer tarafından kaydediliyor açıkçası. Dolayısıyla raporlaması da oldukça basit. Bize en çok gelen sorulardan bir tanesi, bu bir farklı logo değil aslında. Bariz olan kişinin yapmış olduğu işlerle ilgili görüntülerden bahsediyoruz. Dolayısıyla güvenliği çok kritik bu noktada. Observer'ın güvenliğini merkezde encryption uygulayarak yapıyor. Arka tarafta bir MS SQL database'i kullanıyor ama MS SQL'ın güvenliğine çok güvenmiyor bu noktada. Kaynak da IS256 ile encrypt ederek SQL'de hem videoyu hem metadata'yı store ediyor. Kurumunuzun ağına veya kullanacağınız platform sayısına bağlı olarak bir formülasyonu var. Formülasyona bağlı olarak bazı utilizasyonları hesaplıyorsunuz. Ve bu şekilde çok ufak ölçekli kurumlardan, çok büyük ölçekli, 1000-2000 gibi sayıda sunucusu veya altyapısı olan kurumlara kadar ürünü implemente etmeniz oldukça kolay. Soru sorma. Evet, isterseniz başka bir aktif bir sunucu üzerinden, isterseniz Redis üzerinden ikinci otantikasyonu tabi edebilirsiniz. Yani administrator account ile girdikten sonra bu kişinin ismi işte Ozan'sa mesela, sen kimsin sorusunu soruyor. Veya işte bir database sunucuda çalıştığınız zaman sonuçta orada belirli bir kişinin oradasınız. Bir ticket'ınızın olması gerekiyor. ITIL gibi incident handling çözümü sağlayan birçok raporlama aracıyla entegre olabiliyoruz. Bu entegrasyon sonucunda kişi login olduğu zaman ikinci bir soru sorularak burada ne yapacaksın sorusu, varsa ticket ID'nin gir gibi bilgiler veriliyor. Ya da PCI DSS 27001 gibi süreçleriniz varsa bu süreçlerin altında bazı yapacağınız bütün işlemler loglanmaktadır gibi bir takım işlerler yapıyorsun. Ve Observer'ın en güzel şeyi her şeyi report etmek durumunda değilsiniz. Belirli action'lara göre report'u trigger edebiliyorsunuz açıkçası. Bir URL'e girildiğinde, bir uygulama çalıştırıldığında veya bir aktif tarayıcı kullanıcısıyla girildiğinde veya grup üyesi olan bir kullanıcıyla girildiğinde trigger et ya da etme gibi oldukça customizable bir raporlama aracına sahip olabiliyorsunuz. Ki bu platformların hani Unix'te başka, çünkü Unix'te daha çok CLI ile çalışıyorsunuz. Çok grafik, ara bölümünü görmeniz çok mümkün değil. Farklı farklı platformlar için farklı policy'ler kendinize yaratarak devam edebiliyorsunuz ki ürünün offline reporting özelliği de var. Yani database'de agent arasında bağlantı koptuğu zaman 3 milyonata kadar offline reporting özelliği de var. Bu da oldukça kritik. Daha sonra da server'la olan bağlantı sağlandığında elde ettiği logları karşı tarafa atabiliyor. Var. Bizim identity theft dediğimiz bir durum var. Mesela diyelim ki tatile çıktınız. Sizin bilgisayarınızdan olmayan bir lokasyondan bir sunucuya bağlantı yapıyor, bir RDP session yapılıyor. Eğer sizin karakteristik özelliğinize sahip değilseniz size biz bir mail gönderiyor, Observer. Bu kişi siz misiniz, değil misiniz? Eğer siz değilseniz, bu kişi ben değilim, şu anda ben bağlanmıyorum derseniz o maili aktif olarak. İlgili diğer session, aktif olan session kilitleniyor. Dolayısıyla kontrolü bu şekilde sağlıyor olabiliyorsunuz. Yani ürün aslında pasifmiş gibi gözüküyor ama identity theft ve secondary authentication özelliklerine baktığınız zaman aslında intrusive bir durumda var açıkçası.
So thank you everyone.
Teşekkürler.
You can approach Nicola or ask, you are sitting over there. Enjoy your lunch. Thank you very much.